Alaska!
Alyssa Lightning Linduska.
Yes.
Where did that lightning name come from?
It actually came from somebody in the gym named Pierre. Mm-hmm. So he's like really keen to giving people nicknames.
Yeah.
and he's good at it, actually. Yeah. So lightning came because I have a lot of pressure. I throw a lot of strikes.
Yeah.
Pretty fast. And after watching me, he just called me Lightning because it also, you know, there's alliteration with my name, Alyssa Lightning Linduska.
Yeah,
so,
that makes sense.
It just kind of all worked out.
Like, rolls off the tongue. It's great for your striking ability
because
it's like, you know, I'm a little intimidated hearing Lightning, you know.
Oh, really?
I'm sure good. Other people might be too. Yeah, good. That's what we want, people intimidated.
Yes, yes.
Get in their minds.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, so, and speaking of all this training and where the nickname came from, I want to know, did COVID have like an impact on your training, like your regime? So how did that work out for you?
Yeah, so of course, you know, with anything MMA related, you just have to adapt and flow with whatever comes at you. And so nobody predicted what COVID would do to the world or, you know, anything, especially training. And so it was a real opportunity to be flexible, right? Mm-hmm. And so train maybe different parts of your game that you wouldn't normally train.
Yeah.
So since the gym was closed, luckily Danny was still able to have some people, you know, cross train at his home gym, and that was great, but that was a couple times a week.
Yeah.
And so I used the other time to train attributes, right? Mm-hmm. So like I would go for runs. I actually did yoga. Like I had the patience for yoga because I was like, I don't have anywhere else to go in the world, so I guess I'll do an hour of like slow stretching, right?
Yeah.
And so with all of that, I was able to work parts of my game that I would have probably not taken the time to do if the gym was
open. Like, was your, you know, there's obviously some downtime when COVID first started hitting.
Yeah.
So were you training more than usual, would you say? Because you just mentioned you were doing yoga and stuff. But did you, like, do yoga and then go work out and then come?
Yeah, I was trying to do, like, whatever I could, right?
Yeah.
So I was trying to fit in as much as I could.
Yeah.
To make up for not being here.
Wow.
You know?
So in a way, COVID kind of heightened your motivation to become a better fighter? Would you say that?
Yeah, well, I don't know if it heightened because I'm always pretty motivated to be the best that I can be and be an amazing fighter.
Yeah.
What it did challenge me to do is think about how to become a better fighter, right? Mm-hmm. So it didn't make me want to become one more, but it challenged me to think about different ways that I could become better,
that I
probably wouldn't have taken the time to think of before,
wow.
right? Because once you go, like, I mean, we love to compete, we love to hit things, we like to, I don't like to get hit, but, you know, that's the kind of drive that motivates you, and so to not have that, you have to think of, okay, well, how else can I get better?
Yeah, exactly.
So that's,
and then just fill up your day with, like, working out. That's kind of cool, though, because in most cases, you'd hear COVID might hinder like your workout or might make you feel like less motivated, you know?
Yeah.
But it sounds like you kept your motivation. It never, did you ever feel like it died out for a second? Were you like, oh no?
No, the motivation, no, it never, it left. I say one of the challenging part was, you know, not training here at the gym as much as like gaining the weight and like eating.
Oh,
I was like, oh God, cutting
right.
weight again? Is that ever gonna happen?
And
then, you know, here I am. So yes, it did happen. But that was the only, I don't know, scary part, or the only negative part was the weight gain during COVID.
Like the diet?
Yes, yeah, because the diet went out the window. I was
really?
Like, no, I'm always pretty healthy, but like I did eat more sweets than I probably would.
Oh, really?
Would,
so you were just like a little more lenient, you know?
Yes! I think there's a pandemic going on, right? So you have to have some kind of comfort somewhere.
Right, exactly.
And the best is food.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly, like, exactly.
Like, the reason I cut weight is so I can go eat a bunch of food.
Right.
I'm just kidding.
No, that's great. That's cool. Okay, so then with COVID going on and your training happening, you happened to get into a fight camp for November 6th with HRMMA.
Yes.
So on November 6th, we'll talk about that fight soon, but the fight camp before that, was there any like things that COVID impacted with that fight camp, or was it just like easy going?
So the beautiful thing about what I did during the COVID or during the lockdown was that I never stopped training. Mm-hmm. I just focused on different parts, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
when competition arose, mm-hmm. you know, me and then the other people here were able to just like get ready for a fight, right? Because we never really stopped. We just trained differently.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when it was time or when I had an opponent, you know, confirmed, it was like, okay, now I just focus on the game plan, right? You know, because it's not like I had to get back in shape, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. right? Because we were always training something.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was nice to have some goal, right? Like a goal to work towards rather than I'm just busting my butt through COVID. So, you know, to have that goal, it helped.
Having that finish line kind of area that you want to be at in the middle of all this is great.
Yes.
And at the fight camp, how was fight camp? Was it great? Like,
it was tough, like any fight camp. So, this year has been it's been challenges for a lot of people, but for me, I've been working on so many different parts of myself, right? Because it's forcing you to adapt to things that you're not used to. So, for example, during COVID, like I did a lot of yoga, I did a lot of slow movement, stretching, flexibility stuff. Mm-hmm. And then when fight camp came, you know, my competition, lower weight class, like we're faster, we have to be faster and more technical, right? So then that, you know, the stretching and all of that just helped me be a little more limber. And then when the fight was confirmed, I had to focus on being fast and agile, those are things that I always work, but I had such a focus this year on that I haven't had that kind of focus on my game in previous years.
Nice. So, and the fight camp just levitated
to have it's been a lot of hard work. So I'll be glad when it's fight night and you know all the work pays off, but it was great.
Speaking of fight night, what is that day like? Like, walk us through the process of that.
First we weigh in the day before, right? Mm-hmm. Which is like the best feeling in the world when you make weight because you're like hungry leading up to it. That is probably one of the hardest parts.
What do you do right after that?
Drink some water eat some fruit.
And
then breathe.
Breathe.
Yeah, so we weigh in and then like that's like a huge relief, right? Mm-hmm. Because then you just go out there and you do what you do and what you've trained to do, right? Yeah. That's the fun part. Mm-hmm. And so after that, you know, fight day, wake up. For my past couple of fights, I've traveled out of state for them. So, you know, I'm in a hotel with my team and, you know, wake up, go to breakfast. And then, honestly, I probably go back and take a nap after eating. Yeah. And then a couple hours before, I'll get up, do my hair, do everything. And then we'll go to the venue. Mm. And then at the venue, you know, there's a lot of different energies in the back of fights.
Yeah. Yeah,
right?
Because
you've got a lot of... a lot of different characters.
Yeah, well, right? Interesting. So you're seeing those characters like all around you? Okay.
Right, and so for me, I have my own, everyone has their own energy that they have to keep up and the spirit that you perform best in, right? I think our team is great for my energy, right? Because it's very easygoing and laughing and cracking jokes and having fun, right? So when I walk out, a lot of times, or actually, you know, commentators will say, oh, she's so smiley. I don't know if that's going to work for her because people like to have a very serious face on, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But I perform best when I'm smiling and I'm laughing.
Like
and
you
I'm,
feel good.
And I feel good and I love what I do,
right?
And so to have that energy, I just put my headphones in, stay around my team and cultivate that before I walk out on stage.
Nice. Yeah. And I would presume there's some like nerves before fight day or fight night. So how does that feel? Do you ever feel like nervous or do you feel like you have to enter a tunnel to where you get in your zone? Like you said, you cultivate that feeling with your team, you know?
Yeah.
So what's that kind of like?
So I don't feel nerves. I never feel like, I don't feel nervous necessarily about losing. Mm-hmm. Because for me, it's not win or lose, right? Like on paper. Mm. For me, I always want to be the best that I can be. And I work so hard outside of fighting or outside of competing that when I compete, I just want to show what I've been working on. Mm. So my goal is to, I have a goal in between every fight, right? Mm-hmm. And so then what I want to do is just show that in the fight. So when it comes to nerves, it's more about, not showing the best or everything that I've put in, right? And not necessarily about losing or I'm not scared of the person across the cage. And I know that no matter what happens, I'm gonna fight, right?
And like, do the best that
I can do. Yeah, so I don't feel nervous about somebody beating me up.
Right, right. Wow, that's really interesting. And so
I know that at the end of the day, like, I'm not scared.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I just want to show that I'm, everything that I put into it, because right. I do put a lot of work into it.
Yeah, and I could see how, you know, training every single day or yeah. as much as you possibly can could kind of take away those nerves so that way you're prepared.
You're confident.
And you're just going to do the best you can.
Yes, because yeah. you did everything that you knew you were supposed to do, mm-hmm. everything that you could have possibly done. Mm-hmm, you know, mm-hmm. I train in the morning, and then I work a full-time job, and then I come here and I train. Mm. And this fight camp, I did that like 5 times a week.
Wow.
But working from home allows yeah. me to do that, because I don't have to spend the time commuting. I spend the time training now.
Yeah.
Did
you work from home before COVID?
No.
Wow.
So it's so kind of a blessing.
This is a bonus.
yeah.
yeah. Wow, that's
so
great.
So it's kind of a blessing. And yeah. so knowing all the work that I put in to elevate myself and my game, I feel confident going in there.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And just, you know, showing it to everybody.
I saw a recent fight.
Okay. From January.
Yes. And you just totally went in on this girl. I'm not gonna lie, it was great. It was great to see. And then you finished it with the armbar.
Yeah.
And there was like some big struggle on her part in that area. I just want to know what your emotions were in that moment, trying to get that
God.
Clutch. Like, what was it like?
Honestly, so the first round, I felt that I was succeeding, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. And in the round. And I really wanted to finish it in the first round, mm-hmm, right?
Yeah.
And so when it didn't finish, mm-hmm. I think you can probably see in the video, but I stood up, and I'm not trying to be disrespectful to mm-hmm. her at all, but
right,
I was
right.
like, damn it, come on. Like, yeah. I wanted to get out of here.
Like, lit the fire.
Yeah,
you know?
And
yeah.
so then I remember going back to the corner and listening to Danny and Pierre,
yeah.
my coaches,
yeah.
And they were telling me things, and in my head, the only thing that was going on was like, finish this fight.
Yeah.
You don't want it to go
Whoa.
Another round.
Yeah.
And so then, you know, then the second round started, and she, you know, went for the takedown, and mm-hmm. I feel comfortable on my back.
Mm-hmm.
I feel comfortable in that position. So I was mm-hmm. like, okay, we're going to go here, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so as soon as I got it locked in, I knew I had it, and I knew that she didn't like my strikes.
Mm-hmm.
So I just peppered her a little bit and,
mm-hmm.
and finished
mm-hmm.
it. And so, but I went into that second round thinking like, I don't want this to go any longer.
Right,
and
right.
And it was pretty cool to think that
yeah.
and then execute it.
Yeah, and make it happen.
And make it happen.
At the first round, you must have felt very confident in your ability to finish the fight, right? Because the first round was definitely in your favor, would you say? Or
Yeah. The first round was. I think I always go into my fights
mm-hmm.
kind of like a bulldozer.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so when I see that they back up, I'm like, yeah.
yeah.
but
got in their head.
yeah, but of course, like, as competition grows, you're not
yeah.
always gonna meet. You're gonna meet someone who's smarter than.
Mm-hmm.
No disrespect to anybody, but
no,
you're gonna
right,
meet
right,
people
right.
who know how to deal with the pressure like
mm-hmm.
that, right? So
mm-hmm.
that just means that I have to step my game up.
Yes,
as well.
and so in future fights coming up,
mm-hmm.
Are you feeling the same feelings that you were before? Do you feel more confident now that you've been in fights already in the octagon? Or what's the deal there?
Yeah, I feel, so like the more experience, I'll speak for myself, but the more experience that I have competing,
mm-hmm.
They kind of, I don't feel as nervous as like, oh, what's gonna happen?
Yeah.
Or, oh, am I gonna win? Or
yeah.
is it gonna hurt? Or whatever. Yeah. I don't feel those kind of feelings
right,
anymore,
right?
Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so now I just
Great.
Go out there and feel like this is what I do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
I love what I do. I'm not doing it for anybody else other than myself.
Mm-hmm.
And so I have confidence because of that.
That's really cool. That's amazing. And like, I want to know, in your fighting style, in your MMA game, what would you consider are your biggest strengths?
My pressure. No, just get my hands.
Yeah.
yeah. No, I think. Honestly, it's the strength and the weakness, right? Is my mentality
mm.
of being a bulldozer and taking whatever comes, right? Because
yeah.
I know that there's nobody you can put against this cage
mm.
that scares me,
mm,
right?
Mm,
because
mm.
For whatever reasons, you know,
yeah.
there's I've just been through a number of things where anybody that you I accept for you to put in front of me
right, right,
is
right.
not going to scare me as much as other things that I've
wow.
been through.
That's
right?
great, yeah.
And so,
you're just like leveling up now,
yeah.
you know? Yeah. And,
yeah,
and like your mentality is like so strong and fierce. And then now you're working on the body at the same time, so
yeah.
you're
yeah. So having those connects
yeah.
is pretty strong. And so, but with that is also, I recognize is one of my biggest weaknesses,
mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
is that I don't mind getting into a brawl. I don't mind eating shots because, you know, I'm not scared of you.
Right, right.
But that's not good for longevity,
you
right?
You think so, huh? I can see that. Yeah. I can see, yeah.
I mean, you see a number of fighters that have, like, head trauma and damage and all that kind of stuff. And I don't want to ever have that.
Right.
And so while that is a great strength, I don't want to just eat shots because I'm not afraid of eating shots.
Yeah.
So that's definitely been a focus.
That makes sense. And like, let's say after a fight, after you eat some shots, like, what do you feel like the next day? Do you just want to chill or?
Yeah, usually I want to chill, right?
Because
we put ourselves through so much for weeks.
Yes.
Yes, and so I like to just, you know, soak it all in and enjoy time with my family. The best thing is going home to my family, like with my grandma and my brother, and she makes us food, and we just sit and talk, and I don't have to worry about rushing to training or anything. So I do that for probably about a week.
Yeah.
I come here, play around at the gym without like being serious.
Right.
Oh, and it feels so good.
Really?
Yeah, but then the next week is like back to business.
back to business. That's one week off and that's it.
Yeah.
Even slightly.
Yeah.
And does your family really support like your fighting or?
My grandma, she gets scared, right? Like when I show her the videos, I think she just forwards the end and is like, oh, you won! But like doesn't want to watch the in between because she doesn't want to watch like violence.
Yeah.
But they're all pretty supportive.
Yeah, that's really good. But what about in the very beginning when you started fighting? Did they think it was kind of strange or?
I don't think they thought it was strange. I do come from a family of strong women.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have police officers or military people.
Wow.
A lot of strong women, so I don't think it was a surprise or anything abnormal for me to start doing a combat sport.
Interesting. Would you say that was like the start of you wanting to do a combat sport, or what was your initial inspiration?
Well, I joined it because I wanted to lose some weight and get in shape, honestly,
right? Okay.
So, like, I did that, and the thought of competing or fighting in a cage, I was like, only barbarians do that kind of stuff.
and then, boom!
And then here I am.
Yeah, yeah.
Barbaric!
Yeah, barbarian!
And so, and then I stuck with it, and then I am very, very competitive, and I was good at it, and so then I just turned into, competing against other people.
And then did your coach approach you with like a first fight or something? And
so people told me like, are you thinking about fighting? And I'm like, oh, I don't know. I did some grappling competitions, and then after being successful in those, I was like, okay, I could probably, do MMA in a cage.
Yeah.
And then I told Danny that I wanted to fight on this day, and then he made it happen.
Wow. So you approached the situation.
Yeah.
Didn't it come to you? Now, your fighting style, what is your fighting style? Can we talk about that a little bit?
Yeah. So I am a pressure fighter, right? So I move forward.
Mm-hmm.
I like standing, right? Mm-hmm. So I like throwing my hands and kicks and that kind of stuff. I am not afraid to be on the ground and grapple because I'm, confident in my submission skills and stuff. So I think overall, I'm just, a pressure fighter. I like to have control.
Nice.
Maybe as you can tell, as I go first and I know what I want, but I like to have control in the cage as well. I like to dominate where the fight goes.
That's great. And what would you say would be an animal that could channel that? Like if you were to put your fighting style into an animal, animal would it be?
An animal. What's a really aggressive animal? See, like, I like cats, right? So, like, I want to say a cat.
Whoa.
Or, like, some kind of cat, right?
Agile,
like,
huh?
Like,
maybe like a leopard or something?
Yeah. So, when I was young, I always thought a cheetah was my favorite animal.
Yeah.
And I always thought because they were so fast.
Right.
Oh, doesn't that make sense, right? Because
I always liked
them because they were so fast and they have, like, those cool spots on them.
Look at that. Lightning, cheetah.
Yeah.
It makes sense. Your fighting style
is
like a cheetah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We'll say a cheetah then.
We did more than ask that question. We discovered your spirit animal.
I'm pretty sure. I know. I was never into spirit animals, but that's cheetah. I'm going to have to get a cheetah tattoo. Really.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, right. That's what you gotta do now.
Yeah.
Great. Okay, so the fight is coming up on November 6th.
Yes.
You're pretty excited. It seems like you're ready.
Yeah.
Is there any sponsors you want to shout out for that fight?
I have a sponsor, Mitrospec, who supplies Kratom for me for all my camps in, in and out. And so if anybody doesn't know what Kratom is, you know, it's a plant and has different functions based on the strain of it, right? So think of, you know, there's strains for energy or relaxation of the body, of the mind, of, you know, a whole bunch of different strains. They actually created a blend just for me to, in lieu of my spirit, right? And it's called the Lightning Blend, which gives you energy, right? So it has, you know, white and green strains, which give you energy and focus. And then it has cordyceps in there, mushrooms, I love because I always feel like my brain is like super powered when I have those.
Interesting.
And so, yeah, they supply me with everything that I need to get through camp. They're so supportive. Wow. And I've been working with them for like almost 3 years now.
Wow, that's really awesome. And 2 to 3 years with a sponsor, that means like you're really good too. How do you, is it a drink? Like,
no, so it's capsules or capsules. Powders. Oh, yes, little capsules or powders.
Okay, let's say I wanted to buy one. Where could I go?
You go to mitrospec.com, and then you could just search and browse the different strains that they have, and they have little descriptions that tell you what they do, and they have all kinds of stuff on there.
I honestly want to try the lightning one.
Oh, okay.
I want to feel perked up in my head.
Well, I can
go.
Give you a little sample.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Awesome.
Or go to Mitrospec. Everybody go to mitrospec.com.
All right, Alyssa Lightning Linduska.
Yes.
Thank you so much for sitting in on this interview with me.
Oh, thank you.
I hope you enjoyed your time, and I think a lot of people got to know who you are a little bit more.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Mm-hmm. No problem.
Okay.